Hello everyone, welcome to MBBS classes. Myself Dr. Hanifa. Today in this video I'll talk on myringotomy, or which is also called as tympanosynthesis. If we look into the history of myringotomy, it was discovered accidentally when a surgeon called Jean Riolin the younger, when he accidentally punctured the patient's tympanic membrane while he was cleaning the ears. And that point of time, as soon as the tympanic membrane got ruptured, it improved the patient hearing. So with this, the role of incision on the tympanic membrane to improve the hearing, it came into existence. Myringotomy, it is defined as an incision on the tympanic membrane and for the drainage of the middle ear fluid. You can see here, this is the tympanic membrane, one figure. An incision is made on the tympanic membrane from below upwards. Now let us see the indications of myringotomy. The most common indication of myringotomy is acute otitis media. Mostly it is done in cases of patients when they present during the suppurative stage, and the presenting symptom will be fever and an earache. So to relieve the earache and the high fever, the myringotomy is indicated in cases of acute otitis media. Moreover, when the otitis media, it presents with complications like facial paralysis, mastoiditis and labyrinthitis, then also the myringotomy is done. Sometimes in cases of unresolved otitis media, where the middle ear fluid, it fails to resolve after a course of antibiotic, then sometimes it is indicated. The next indication of myringotomy is in cases of otitis media with effusion. The aim of doing myringotomy in otitis media with effusion is to obtain the samples of the middle ear fluid for culture, when the fluid is persisting for a longer duration of time. Moreover, in otitis media with effusion, when a child needs tympanostomy tube insertion, then the myringotomy is combined with the tympanostomy tube insertion. Very rarely, sometimes in cases of barotraumatic otitis media, when the conservative measures it fails, then myringotomy sometimes is required. And for the management of adhesive otitis media and atelectasis, it may be needed sometimes. Myringotomy is generally done under general anesthesia, because most of the patients, they belong to the pediatric age group. Now let us see the instruments. This procedure is done under general anesthesia under the visualization of the operating microscope. There are certain basic instruments which are needed for the myringotomy. We need oral speculum, that is the ear speculum. For doing the myringotomy, generally we have to keep at least 3 to 4 different sizes of the speculum. As you can see in this figure, these are the ear speculum. Next is the myringotomy knife with which the incision is made. It is a sharp type of knife. This is the myringotomy knife with which the incision is made. The next instrument which is required is the suction cannula with attachments for sucking out the middle ear fluid. This is the suction cannula and its attachment. For holding the tympanostomy tube in cases of otitis media with effusion, sometimes we require micro ear forceps or crocodile forceps, as you can see here in this figure. This is a picture of the micro ear forceps. There are different types of incisions of myringotomy, and the type of incisions, it depends on the type of disease. The incisions for acute otitis media, it varies from the incision which is made for the otitis media with effusion. Now let us see what is the type of incision in acute suppurative otitis media. So this is a picture of a normal tympanic membrane. For better understanding, if you see here, in cases of acute suppurative otitis media, the incision is single curvilinear incision. It is a curvilinear incision, it is a single incision, and the direction of incision is always from below upwards. So the reason for the incision being below upward is that when we make an incision over the drum, the draining fluids will not obscure the incision site. Mostly it is done at the point of maximum bulging. So as you can see here, this is a tympanic membrane of a patient presenting with the in the suppurative stage of the acute suppurative otitis media. So the tympanic membrane, if you see here a case of ASOM, it is totally bulged in the posterior inferior quadrant and it is totally congested. So in this case, the myringotomy incision will be curvilinear, as you can see here, and it is usually given at the point of maximum bulge. And if the sometimes for better understanding, the incision is made in between the umbo and the posterior canal wall. Suppose while doing myringotomy, if accidentally a double incision is made, like one incision from below upwards here, and if another incision accidentally is made parallel to the first incision, then in those cases it may lead to the permanent perforation of the tympanic membrane as a complications. The reason being that the blood supply of the membrane is by end arteries. In otitis media with effusion, the site and size of the incisions, it differs from that in ASOM. Here the size is smaller because the small size is adequate for draining the fluids, and the site, it can be posterior based or anterior based, and the incisions, they are always made radially. The incisions are always radial. In ASOM we have seen it is curvilinear. In otitis media with effusion, the site of the incisions is always radial along the direction of the fibers. The incision can be given in the anterior inferior quadrant, you can see here, or in the posterior inferior quadrant, or for remembering, it can be given at 7 o'clock position or 5 o'clock position. And the size usually is smaller than it is used for the ASOM. The anterior inferior quadrant incision is preferred when the myringotomy is combined with the insertion of the tympanostomy tube, as it is seen that the grommet remains in place for a longer time. This type of radial incision, it is seen it minimizes the scarring of the tympanic membrane. So when we are draining a fluid in cases of otitis media with effusion, the first incision is used with the aim to insert the grommet. Now what is the role of the second incision? The second incision is generally recommended when the secretions is very tenacious and it is difficult to suck. Moreover, when the second incision is made, it allows the air to enter the tympanic cavity and prevents the negative pressure from increasing the difficulty of aspiration. So there are certain complications which may arise because of the procedure. So let us see what are the complications. So the most common complication which is seen is usually the tympanic membrane perforation, which is seen usually at the site of grommet insertion, or in cases of ASOM, if a double incision is made, it can lead to a permanent perforation of the drum. There is a possibility of injury to the ossicles, the most common being incus and the incudostipedial joint, when the incision is made in the posterior superior segment of the tympanic membrane. If accidentally the myringotomy knife, if it injures the inner ear, then it can lead to injury to the round window. In cases with the congenital dehiscence along the floor of the tympanic cavity, in those cases, if the jugular bulb and internal carotid artery, they are prone to injury while doing the procedure. Now there are separate set of complications which are related to the insertion of grommet. Like it is seen that there may be thinning of membrane or atrophy of membrane, or there may be a tympanosclerosis, which is the deposition of hyaline-like material in the tympanic membrane. Then because of these thinning and atrophy of the membrane, the tympanic membrane is more prone to develop retraction pockets and secondary or acquired type of cholestatoma. Then there may be development of intratympanic cholestatoma in the long-term period. If the grommet is inserted, there is a possibility that it might be displaced into the middle ear, or it can If it is not displaced, sometimes the grommet may stay in place for a long period of time that may need another surgical procedure for the removal of the grommet. With this, I come to an end of this video. Thank you for watching this video.